call.
Morning, y'all. Right, first things first.
Joseph Mayo here at TPC Summerlin.
Tweet of the day.
One of my students came to see me, ironically, from Texas. And he's got several friends down in the Houston area that have been affected by Hurricane Harvey. So I had the idea, and I want to challenge every instructor out there watching to do the same thing. I took $100 out of the lesson fee that he paid me today, and I'm going to donate it to the Red Cross as soon as I get done filming this video. And everybody else out there that's in the golf industry, if you can afford it, I want you to take $100 out of your lessons today, and I want you to give it to the Red Cross to help these people down in Houston and the surrounding areas that have been affected by this horrible tragedy. These people need our help. We can help. So let's do it, guys. I challenge you to do it.
Joe Mayo, Trackman Maestro, I accept your challenge, Joe. I'm going to go for $100. Done. Any golf pros out there, if you can afford it, do the same, or just donate what you can afford. And anyone watching, great tweet, Joe. Right, today's video is going to talk about swing plane, the term swing plane. I still get some very funny questions around swing plane. I'm still seeing loads of quite content around swing plane. Let's talk to you about why it's a term I don't use with my students and how I see a big percentage of them, when we try to talk the term swing plane, it's very obvious that their understanding of it is holding them back. Let's show you what I mean. Let's kick this off by defining what is meant by swing plane. And then we'll start challenging. So what you're gonna see swing plane relate to is often this angle, so on the way back. So a swing that might be on plane. This club is gonna point at some magical spot. And then on some downswing action, you then get again this angle. Obviously always caught at an exact point. Where the shaft will point at your kind of magic spot as well. And the idea is if you hit those magical swing plane points, then everything's good. So you'll swing on the right path. You'll have the right face to path control, and you'll have great angle of attack and control of low point, which we're going to challenge today. So the question that I ask my students always that comes out in lessons, when they mention that they've been working for a while or trying to get on plane, I challenge them to this question. I want you to post in the comments down below before watching the rest of the video and try not just to tell me what you think. Try not to tell me what you think I want you to answer, because so don't mind if you're getting it wrong. That's why we're making these videos. So we have this magical on plane term. Now, if I'm below that angle, that means my path will be too much into out. And then have this magical term, and I'm above this angle, over this imaginary plane, that's gonna make me too much out to in. Down in the comments down below, that's the first one we're gonna tackle, down there. Let me know, is that right or wrong in your minds? Just be honest. Right, Team Parfield home today, and this house doesn't seem to have tidied itself up. This understanding of plane has no bearing on path, none. So let's take this putter on the floor here, a zero path down where I'm hitting. If I get my downswing perfectly on plane, but I'm gonna take this to extremes, was to hit the ball here, so on the way down, you can see at this point, my path of my club is right. It's not had time to straighten up. So if I was to hit the ball on the way down, on this perfect plane, my path's in to out, going right. Then flip side of that, I can get on plane again here, and I could strike the ball, say here, so heavily on the way through. You can see here now my path is going left. But I was on plane for both swings, yet I had a path which was 20 right, and then the next path which was 20 left. Obviously, I'm showing that in extreme formats of down and up, but when it comes to putting the downward or upward element of your swing into it, it shows you that trying to get on plane probably won't stop your slice, subject to other things you're doing. It won't, as I see from student after student, change anything. I've had students before who've worked on getting on plane for years. They come for one lesson and we switch their path, face to path, shot shape within 2 seconds, because you get them to stop thinking about plane, because like lots of you down in that comment section down below probably think that under and over plane does relate to path. Path is not plane, and plane, if you talk to the scientists, in the way golf pros use it, doesn't really exist. time to collecting Parfield from the train station. I've arrived a little bit early. Team Parfield has made it. Funny noise. So if plane doesn't affect path, so surely it must affect angle of attack for people to want to get on plane. So I'm going to use the viewfinder here in my camera. If I make the club vertical on the downswing and then come down to hit my imaginary ball with this tiny putter, I can have a downward angle of attack, I can have a zero, and I can have an upward. It doesn't really make any difference. It has no kind of relevance to what my angle of attack might be. Now, if I put the grip at the corner of the viewfinder so your screen as you watch it, again, club goes up and down, same angle, plane as people think. Again, I'm hitting down, zero, level with the table, and then up. Again, it makes no difference. The only difference it would make is if I stayed at zero the whole way. So the ultimate around swing, then up and down would be impossible. But obviously no one's starting with their handle on the ground. Handle's in the air, handle's going above for someone's head. The angle it comes down on, so what people would call over the top steep compared to flat or stuck behind you, all those kind of comments, it's not relating to path and it's not relating to angle of attack either. Ooh. Or what is it relating to? Oh, I don't know who did this, Mark, shown on the old table. Wasn't me. Yeah, it wasn't me. No, I've not seen that.
Yeah, there is a mark.
That's from the kids, I think.
Hey!
So I threw the term swing plane out to social media and asked for their take on the ideas of swing plane. Just a few of the responses. So David said, Mark, I struggle with an in to out path from dropping it behind me too much, from which gives me a nice draw or a shank. From not recovering the club head, what's the easiest way to practice to get it more neutral? So this is a classic example, I'm guessing, without seeing his swing, of someone who thinks that they're getting too far this way, which pushes their path too far to the right, which is where they draw and hit a few shanks. Well, we've already established that angle doesn't dictate path. So you see where it breaks down, it doesn't quite work. Often actually with these players, what you find is that they get the handle very high through impact, and there comes lots of the shanks from that kind of chucking that handle up and that shifting of the vertical swing plane. Trackman used to call it, I call it dynamic lie, how they lie the club on the ground can affect how they deliver the neck or the middle or the toe. But again, see, you can't answer his question because it's flawed from that beginning of ideas of plane. Scott says a similar thing. Can you shallow the club too far? If you can, would this cause the club to get stuck behind, or is it purely caused by firing the body too much too early? I don't really know what Scott's asking there. And again, it breaks down from the start because we've established that that angle, which he thinks, I'm guessing, is plane, doesn't relate to club path. And then you go on, someone like Jason says, is it just me, or is looking too much into things complicating the game? Well, understanding these points don't make you better at it. You've got to understand that's important to realize, but understanding these points might make you learn quicker in a lesson, ask the right questions, certainly through social, those kind of ideas. And then there's our plenty as well, which say, Nigel says, is it as important as the shaft? He's joking with a little smiley face. What does plane mean? Does it matter? Nah, it's a myth. And so there are plenty of you now, I think, really starting to understand that they aren't the same things. The understanding of plane, which really most good coaches I know don't relate to plane anymore, if they did, because they've understood how I think the general learning public relate it so directly to things like path and angle of attack when they're not related. So what I find makes a massive difference when you get people stopping or changing their understanding of plane is when you get them to understand the difference between your hand path and, say, the head or center of gravity path. So what I mean by that, if you imagine my hands have come from here, so over my right shoulder, to get to this position. Well, they're going on one path, and the club, if its sweet spot is getting below that path, often causes good things in golf swings. Then the club is going on a different plane and a different path. To the hands, it's when you start thinking that they marry up and then relate to your path and your angle of attack, that's when you start getting in a mess. When you understand that you want to just try and get the center of gravity under your hand path, that's when you start making huge breakthroughs with golfers. The other thing to understand here as well is this angle that you set down on the downswing doesn't relate to face the path, because we're hopefully agreeing that this angle isn't relating to path, so you don't know what face orientation to use in relationship to not knowing what path you might deliver, subject to being down or up. So that angle that we know is plane, it's not relating to path, it's not relating to angle of attack, and it's not relating to face to path. This is why it's a term I don't use with students, because often they're relating them to all those three things. So we're stuck unless we change, one of us changes our ideas. And the thing that often helps me is that my ideas around their ideas plane, I can prove to them very quickly within one or two swings that we can change their ideas and get them to hit better shots. Then they buy in, they're in. There we go, thanks for watching. Classic spag bowl tonight. So let me know down below in that comment section if this all makes sense. If it doesn't, and look, if you're someone who's been thinking about swing plane and getting on a certain angle and your golf is getting better, keep doing it. But let me know in that comment section down below if it makes sense, if it doesn't, and if it has changed your ideas on the importance of getting on plane or not. I would love to hear. Comment section, thumbs up, daily vlogs, as always. And don't be afraid to hit that subscribe button. It's got a knife in my hand as I said that. See you all tomorrow. Friday, there's gonna be a big change on Friday. Funny noise.